Here's a grouping of Lionel pre-war items, some standard gauge and O-gauge items that you might find interesting. I'm going to zoom in and pan the camera and I'll describe them one by one. We're going to start in the back with the cars, and first thing I'm going to zoom in on is the Lionel number 219 crane. This is called Late Colors. This particular one has a red roof and an ivory cab with the green boom. It's a very, very elaborate toy. This one was made in the late 1930s because these are called Late Colors, and that's why they chose to do that. A very interesting toy. Basically, it's almost a standalone item. It was very popular with kids back in the 30s. The next car that you'll see is the Lionel number 212 gondola. It's a fairly common car, but this particular gondola is carrying a load of containers, LCL containers, which are really, they're number 205, they're called merchandise containers, and they're often found with this car. They make really a great companion item, and they're often seen lifted by the boom on the crane, as you can see hovering right above it. Next car is the Lionel number 220 searchlight car. This one is in the rare late colors. It has the green base with nickel lights and nickel trim. And last but not least, a Lionel number 217 caboose. This particular one has a red main structure and a peacock roof. It has a lighted rear deck, and this car was made in the early 1930s. Going back just a little bit, the tall item you can see is the number 80 Semaphore. This one is electrically operated, and this one came with a special track. When the train ran over it, the arm would lift. Last but not least, going to the front, we have a set of barrels. These are two-piece wooden barrels, number 209. There's a set of six of these barrels. Interesting, they come apart. They're often seen again in the gondola car. And off to the left, with its original box, is the Lionel toolbox set number 208. And you can see the tools in the aluminum case. These are often seen inside the gondola car. And of course, the original Lionel box is with it. Moving down to the very front here, here's an O-gauge number 270 girder bridge with a piece of O-gauge track. And directly behind that is the O-gauge number 47 double arm crossing gate. And each of the little gates has a light on it. They will both come down concurrently when activated. So I hope you've enjoyed this tour through this interesting group of cars and accessories, and hope to see you again on our channel sometime very soon. Be safe, have a great day, thanks for looking.